you want to get a kid stronger, you have to pump as much oxygen to their muscles as possible. So how I started my whole deal was, I think my son, who's 9 now, my middle son, he was almost 4 years old. And we were outside in the back and we were sitting on a bench. And he told me, he said, "Daddy, I want to be like Barry Sanders when I grow up." And that's really where it started, because I didn't know any trainers. I didn't know of any. I didn't know how to train. I didn't know any of that. So he really made me figure it out. So at the beginning, you know, I started looking at little basic drills on the ladder, you know. So we started doing little basic stuff. I still have the videos when he was 3 years old. And I took him to maybe a couple of trainers here and there until as I was taking him to those trainers, I was trying to figure out, are they doing anything different than what you're doing? And it wasn't much difference. So I just started studying from there and went deeper and applied it to him, And it must have been his first flag football game where I saw him do this amazing spin move, trip me out, tripped the whole crowd out, you know. And of course they asked me, how did he do that? And I'm like, well, I did it. You know, I've been blah, blah, blah. And then they were like, okay, you do it to my kid, da, da, da. So it started like kind of on the street type deal, you know, $10 here, $10 here. And then one day, you know, me and my wife, we were laying in bed watching TV, and she paused the TV and she was like, you know, you can do this yourself. And I was scared. I said, you think so? She said, yeah, you can do it yourself. So, you know, as I kept applying it to him, I opened the door, you know. And of course, when you open the door, ain't nobody in here. Don't nobody know who I am, you know what I mean? So then it just kind of started growing a little bit by little, you know. And now I'm to where I'm okay, you know what I mean? Hopefully it get bigger and bigger and bigger, you know. So that's how it all started. I don't want it to get too big, I guess, so to speak. I don't want it to be where I have this huge building and I got 6 or 7 or 10 different trainers in there that don't have the same passion as I do. And then they're putting out, I can't oversee everybody, so then they're putting out a product that I would never do, you know, or they're teaching their kid wrong or not like I would do it, you know what I mean? So I just see myself staying by myself for at least a couple more years, you know. The impact that I wanted to leave with the kids is that it's a place where you can express yourself. It's a place where you can make mistakes and it's okay. It's a place where Coach Hobbs has made, I want a kid to feel like that I make them feel like that they can do anything they want to do on the football field. You know, I don't just bring the kids in and train them and send them out the door. You know, I tap into their mind. I joke with them, I laugh with them, I ask them what they ate, because I also do the nutrition side too. So I talk to them about, I mean, I've had kids in here tell me all kind of stuff, you know what I mean? Because I make them feel like, I'm your friend, I care about you, but I'm also your trainer. So when it's time to work, it's time to work. But if there's something wrong, you can tell me about it, because I also have to remember these are kids. They will come in here in a terrible mood just for whatever reason. I don't know if you just had an argument with your parents in the car or whatever. You got your lip poked out. Let's talk about it. You don't have to tell me everything, but let's talk about it so I can get you to where what we need, so we can get through what we need to get through. You know, they will never know it. I don't let them know. I have a lot of patience, and sometimes, yeah, I do get frustrated. But they don't know it. They never know. I still stay encouraging to them. I still tell them that they can do it when they don't feel like they can. And even when they tell me that they can't, I tell them like this. If you say you can't, you're right. If you say you can, you're right. So let's go. You know, so on the strength and conditioning part is I had to break it down. It's all a science. So our bodies are electric. Okay, so the electricity flowing through your muscles along with the oxygen. So if you want to get a kid stronger, you have to pump as much oxygen to their muscles as possible, more than an adult, to get them to react. All the footwork and the fun stuff that we just did the video on, that's all well and cool. It's cool, you know, but there's more levels to it. You know, there, it's more than just running around some cones or some hexagon or some hurdles. You know, it's a lot. It's a science to it. It's not just that part. You know what I mean? For a beginner athlete, of course, it's going to be different than a kid that's already, you know, advanced, so to speak, or whatever. So it just depends on where they're at, you know. So what I do when they come in, I assess the kid. I see where his agility is first. I see where his body control is. I see where his strength is. I see where his conditioning is. So I take that into consideration. That assessment is going to determine what we do next, and then what we do next, and then what we do next. So after every kid leaves, after every session, I go write down how that kid did. I'm going to give him a 1 to 10 that he'll never know about. Okay, that's for me. So, and then the parents that do come in here and record the things that I'm doing, I don't put all those videos on Instagram or Facebook. Those videos are for me, so I can see where the mistakes were, so I can see what we need to go back to and when we need to go back to, and how many times you did that same mistake and how bad that mistake was made in that particular drill. Because for me, these kids come, most of the time they come in the off season, right? So the off season to get ready for the season. So when the kid comes in January, I know I got a list of things to do before we put a helmet back on. Because I know when he puts that helmet back on, before he's done in here, his friends, his family, his coaches, everybody's gonna know that he's been in here. So I can't put out mediocrity, what I call mediocrity, you know, because everybody's gonna turn and look at me. Like I said before, there's nobody in here but me. So there's nobody else to blame it on but me. Even if the kid, let's say it was a lazy kid, and if the kid is lazy enough, I'm gonna tell the parent, hey, look, I don't wanna take your money, because everybody's gonna look at me. So all I need is a kid who wants it. I don't need a kid who's this super freak athlete. I don't need it. I don't need that. I can take him from the bottom and take him up. I'm not saying we're going to get to the top, but I'm going to say we're not staying at the bottom. So I can take the five-year-old. I've had five-year-olds. I've had four-year-olds. It doesn't matter. Right now I got 5 years old all the way up to 14. It doesn't matter. I just have a passion to do it, and this is what I want to do, and that's just what it's going to be.